What's good, everybody? It's your boy, O'Shea Duke Jackson. Back at it again with another episode of the Celebrity Junk. Guys, you know, in the manosphere, we call when a man understands the real nature of women and who they really are, according to how we feel in these spaces. When a guy comes to that understanding, he then goes through what is known as red pill rage. All right? And red pill rage is pretty much is when a guy will basically start to share his frustrations. You could even call it, you know, disrespecting women, calling them names, anger, you know, some levels of disrespect towards women, or towards the women that have, usually it's toward the women that have they've been in relationships with, right? And this goes on for some people 1 month, 1 year. For some guys, they can become even completely black pill, where that red pill rage is kind of just throughout the rest of their life, right? And Dr. Dre is going through what is red pill rage, because he's found out that his wife never loved him. She never cared about him. The only thing that she wanted him for was his money. And the red pill rage comes out in this new song called Greedy Biatch. All right? And I want to just look at some of the lyrics. He goes, trying to kill me with them lies and that perjury. I see you trying to F me while I'm in surgery. And I used to deathbed on some money-ish. Greedy bitch, take a pick. Girl, you know how money get. And we're talking about his brain aneurysm, that which he could have passed. And, you know, the whole song hasn't been released, at least right now. But we do know that she's been trying to make his life a living hell. Asking for money. Accusing him of taking care of other women. But I think the person at Dr. Dre is not really mad at Nicole Young. He's really angry at himself. And I think for a lot of guys, and a guy like Dr. Dre knows, that all things being equal, if it wasn't his money, okay? A lot of guys know this. The woman that they're dealing with would never be with them. Okay? She was with Sadell 3 before, so you know that she was somewhat of a groupie. She's an attorney. Dr. Dre is not. All right? You know, Dr. Dre at the time was a little overweight. She was considered exceptionally really beautiful. And what Dr. Dre was looking for was a woman to love him for him. Not just him being a record producer. And the thing is, she made him feel like she really loved him for him. Maybe she even lied to herself to make herself believe that she loved him for him. But the real situation is they were unequally yoked. Okay? Let's just call it for what it is. You're the guy that, unfortunately, you're the breadwinner. Okay? She went through the motions of having your children, went through the motions of getting the bag. And you loved her. And she didn't love you back. And so now, she's a greedy bitch. But you knew that when you married her. She was greedy when you took her away from Sadell 3. She was greedy when she was a groupie. But you wanted her anyway. Because see, Dr. Dre, you thought you were special. And I want guys to understand, this is how a lot of women who deal in spaces like in the industry, women who target guys who are rappers, who are ball players. A lot of these women know that these guys don't have high self-esteem. Okay? Outside of them being successful as rappers, as ball players, these guys don't have high self-esteem. And to be honest, a guy like Dr. Dre, who had a tumultuous relationship with his mom, you know, didn't have a really good relationship with women. He's a guy that has a lot of money, but he has a lot of problems, a lot of instability. So these women understand that they're not dealing with a guy that has a lot of home training, a lot of guy that has a lot of... So if they can come in and manipulate those things and make a guy feel real good about himself and pretend to show a guy love that's never really received it and say some nice things to him, those guys are hooked. Those guys think they have somebody. You know, you think highly of yourself, like, oh man, you know, I deserve this, I deserve that. But the thing is, it's just business. And a lot of men have understood that the woman that they've been with 20, 30, 40 years, hey man, it was never about love. It's just business. And when you take the red pill on this, it then becomes too late. All right? Especially when you know that a woman is out of your academic circle. You know, you're a gangster rapper. She's an attorney. Okay? Now, in some cases, you know, a woman who's an attorney will date a gangster rapper if, you know, if she feels like he's very sexy. Dr. Dre was fat at the time. All right? In order for him to get hurt, he had to bring something to the table. And what he brought to the table was money, promise, being an astute businessman, having a hard work ethic. Well, what does she have to bring to the table? Nothing. Just being looking good, light skin. All right? Now Dr. Dre is pissed off. Some of his kids probably have turned on him. He can't believe he's sick and the lady that he thought that had his back was going to be like this. Guess what, bro? That's the true nature of how it is. And I think for a lot of guys out there, when you're dating somebody that's, you know, typically if your money couldn't get you there out of your typical league, meaning that, you know, her attractiveness is so great that it's, you know, much, much more than what you usually get. We see the same case with Kevin Garnett, Scottie Pippen, and Larsa Pippen. Hey, this woman don't love these guys. All right? The women that probably really loved you are, you know, women that look more closer to what you can typically get. This is why Bill Gates, if you look at Bill Gates and Melinda Gates, want to know why Bill Gates and Melinda Gates will always stay together? Look at Melinda Gates and look at Bill Gates, okay? See, Bill Gates doesn't go out and try to, you know, get somebody that's so exceptionally attractive. You know, he sticks in his lane, okay? Sticks in his lane. He's gonna do that. He plays it safe. A woman that's more likely to like him for him. But when you deal with one of these women, that, hey, it's his business, you're upset. And at 55, Dr. Dre has taken the red pill, which is interesting because you've been rapping about these hoes ain't shit all your life. It's just interesting for a rapper to go through this. Like in the 90s and 80s, that's all you guys talked about. You know, but it's so funny when the rappers don't take the red pill that they're giving out in their music. I mean, a lot of brothers in the hood got red pilled because of hip hop. But oh, I guess simping is still real. Guys, it's your boy O'Shea Deke Jackson. Back at it again. Another episode of The Celebrity Drunk. I really appreciate you for all that you do. Subscribe with the bell. Check out the first comment pinned at the top. Check out the Patreon. And as you know, The buffoonery remains at an all-time high. I'm out.